Hey guys, in this video I wanted to talk about a data visualization called an UpSet plot. So I have an example UpSet plot here, and an UpSet plot is used basically as an alternative to a Venn diagram, and it's usually used as an alternative where you have many sets. So instead of having a busy diagram like this, it's become more common to use something called an UpSet plot. So in this video, I wanted to talk about how you can read an UpSet plot, and then I have a short R demo for how you can create an UpSet plot in R that I will talk about afterwards. So let's go ahead and get started with the video. So I found this sample data set online, and I'll put a link in the description box below to this Venn diagram. But as you can see, this is a Venn diagram that has four sets. So it has A, B, C, D, and then it has data that can belong to any of the sets. So for example, 50, in this case, this was like sampled genes. And so in this case, there are 50 genes that just belong to set A. There are 144 that just belong to set B. But then you can also have sets or genes that belong to multiple sets. So for example, 46 is the sample size that belongs to both A and B, but not C and D. And then, for example, you have sample data that belongs to A, B, C, and D, which is 24. So basically, that's how you read this type of Venn diagram. And so it gives you set membership information. And like I said in the beginning of the video, it's been more common to visualize this type of set information when you have many sets using an UpSet plot instead of a Venn diagram. So this is the equivalent visualization using an UpSet plot for this same data. And I will show you how I created this data in R. How do you read this plot? So this is what's called an UpSet plot. And you basically read the data as follows. You have your set information or your set membership here. So you have A, D, C, B. And this, I ordered it in terms of frequency, but you can change that or customize that as well. And then the dots and the lines here represent the set membership. So for example, you have some data that just exists in set A, B, C, and D, and that would be represented just by the dots. So for example, for the sample genes that just exist in a set A, that would correspond to this column here because it has just a dot membership in A. And then the sample size is given as a bar graph on top of this portion of the visualization. So here we see that the sample size for samples that just exist in set A is 50. And then if we go back up to the Venn diagram, we see that that is correct. So that's how you would read just the dots. So we have A, B, C, D here. And then for the line segments that have the dots with the lines connected to them, that is for intersections. So for example, if we look at the last column here, this is for the samples that have membership in A, D, C, and B. So we know that because the dots for A, B, C, and D are filled in and the lines are connecting them as well. And it says here that the sample size is 24. And again, we know that that's true from looking at the Venn diagram. Then on the left-hand side here, we also have just the set information. And since I ordered by frequencies, we can also get that just from the order. So we see that set B has the largest sample size, then C, then D, then A. So we see that both in the bar graph and also in the ordering of the bar graph. And so that's basically how you read an UpSet plot. So in the next section, I'll show how you can create this plot in R. Okay, so I switched to an R window. This tutorial is going to be very short, but basically to plot an UpSet plot in R, you have to have a package called UpsetR installed. I already installed that package, so I'm just going to load it in using library. And then this line of code I got from a website for the Venn diagram. So this is the website, and I'll put the link in the description box below. And that's the sample data that they used to create the Venn diagram. This is actually a tutorial for creating Venn diagrams in R. So if I run this line of code from that page, it gives me a list object that has all the sample data that I'm going to use to create the UpSet plot instead of the Venn diagram. So running this next line of codes just gives me the same exact data as in the Venn diagram. And so it's a list object, and it's a list of four vectors. So every vector is a set, and it has the names here, A, B, C, D, like we just showed before. So to create an UpSet plot, I'm going to use this list object. So if you're creating this type of data or loading in this type of data from scratch, one way to create an UpSet plot is you want to create the data as a list of vectors, where your vectors are your sets. And since I already have that loaded in as X, the line of code to create an UpSet plot is just one line. So there's a function UpSet that will create the data visualization. And then from list is also a function from UpSet R. And from list, you just pass in the name of your list object. And then optionally, I put order by to give you the decreasing frequencies. So running this line of code gives me the data visualization, again, ordered by frequency. And so there are customizations that you can do to this. For example, you can add color to certain sets that you want to emphasize. But this is the basic way to create an UpSet plot in R. And that's it for this video.